Hello, Prosper High School. I'm Colby Thompson.
And I'm Nicole Phillips, and this is Eagle TV.
So, Nicole, what do you plan to do after you graduate high school?
I'm not sure yet, but I do know that Christina Ordonez, a former PHS student, has made a name for herself as Miss Collin County. Let's go check out her story.
I would describe her as probably outgoing.
Beautiful. Beautiful. Both inside and out.
Friendly and compassionate.
Christina Ordonez is a Prosper High School alumni whose beauty is more than skin deep. Winner of the Miss Collin County USA pageant, Ordonez has gone to compete at state level, proving that Prosper pride doesn't end at graduation.
When I was about 11 years old, I did my first pageant in California where I used to live. And it was Miss Preteen Norco, and I went ahead and actually won that pageant. So I enjoyed it. It was an absolute blast. And then 5-6 years ago, I actually moved here to Prosper, Texas. And I've always wanted to try to do a pageant here, but God has never given me the opportunity. And so he gave me the opportunity this following year. And so I jumped right on that and just started training from Miss Texas and absolutely loved it and had a great time. The quality that probably prepared me is confidence. When entering into pageant, there are a lot of gorgeous women there and you have to have confidence to compete. Collin County.
She was always really outgoing, funny, playful.
Her time at Prosper High shaped who she is today.
Prosper High School has amazing teachers, very encouraging teachers no matter what. I think my favorite teacher here was probably Meredith Hamilton. She was by far the greatest teacher I had. She helped me with everything and always kept me going and was very, very uplifting. And so that brought me a lot of confidence. I think I had about 100 students in my class at the time. And immediately when I came in, I was with my twin sister. So everyone, of course, looked at us, twins. Students here were so kind and just brought us into their group of friends. And we had an absolute blast. I don't think I ever felt like I did not fit in.
My freshman year here, I was new to the school and I didn't know anyone. So she and her sister Nicole were the people who showed me around and ate lunch with me.
As an older sister, she's really a role model to me. And a lot of stuff I do is based on things that she's done. And she just helps me a lot through tough times or through anything that I'm going through.
She supports her family and friends, and they support her too.
They were actually so supportive. They drove out there to Houston with me to watch me compete. Were there every single day. My mom actually went and worked out with me sometimes because I did have to work out every single day throughout the week. And my sister helped me pick out my dress. She went shopping for me, was there for my meltdowns because I had several meltdowns during the pageant, but she was there for everything. And my parents made shirts and they were there for everything. And actually my family from California, Ecuador, New York, Virginia, they all went ahead and watched live on the webcam as well and watched me there too. So that was great. They were very, very supportive.
This is Malaysia White reporting for Eagle TV.
Well, Christina has made an impact not only on her friends at Prosper, but here in Texas as well.
There's a new system here at PHS for students who need help. Here's Destiny Nelson with more information on Talk About It.
Talk About It is a school-wide anonymous service to provide advice to students in need.
Because most students nowadays have phones, so it's an easier way to talk about it without people knowing your direct problem.
So you can text or use other methods to reach out to other people.
So if you need advice or knows a friend that might, go and grab a slip off the wall anywhere in PHS to talk about it. This is Destiny Nelson for Eagle TV.
As Memorial Day has passed, students at Rucker Elementary honor their veterans.
On September 11th, Donna Sedota was recognized for her volunteer efforts for Honor Flights for Veterans. Ms. Sedota's guests, Mr. Raymond Murphy and Mr. John Blaze, were also applauded for their service in World War II. After the ceremony, we got an inside look at what Honor Flights are all about.
Honor Flight is a national organization composed completely of volunteers, and our main purpose is to get World War II veterans to Washington, D.C. to see their memorial.
Honor Flight was probably one of the neatest things in the world. My wife and I had been on many trips throughout the world, but this was a trip that I kind of anticipated. I really didn't know what I was going to get into.
We loved our country, we served, and we hope that we will leave you a better country for our services.
And I love my country. I love my heritage, don't get me wrong. But I love my country. I love my country more than anything else in the world.
This is Elise Parker and Michelle Vega signing off for Eagle TV.
What a great way to support our veterans. This next segment is for all you film buffs out there to add a little flavor to your weekly news.
Hello everyone, this is Forrest Ford with your new segment, Movie Reviews. I'm glad we're doing this just so I can add a little flavor to your weekly news from Eagle TV. So, let's begin! At the time I'm recording this, I haven't really seen that much movies recently. The last one being Ted, which I saw in July maybe, I can't really remember. And since that was rated R, I can't really review that, but you can watch it there. So let's make this easy on myself with reviewing the highest grossing movie this year so far, and kind of the most anticipated movie to come out this year too, The Avengers.
Director Fury, I think it's time.
Yeah, I know, cliche, but I want to review this once in my life. I may never review this movie if this show isn't successful with y'all. So now, on to The Avengers, and yeah, this movie was worth the wait. And we had so many movies to build up with this one big epic cinematic masterpiece. We had Iron Man, we had The Incredible Hulk, we had Iron Man Wants to Cash In, we had Thor, and finally Captain America. Five movies, and then we have number six. The amount of buildup that was with these movies ever since that after credits scene with Iron Man 1, and yet that made me really excited too. But with excitement, there's disappointment usually. And was I disappointed when this movie got released? Nope. When I heard Josh Whedon, and I think I've always said his name wrong, so any of those other movie freaks can correct me, when I heard he was the writer or director of this, I had hope. Because Josh Whedon understands how to write characters. He knows what they think, he knows how to separate them, and he knows how to make them kind of believable. So, other than that, what do I think of the movie? Well, what do I hate about the movie? The plot seems rushed. I'm very sorry, but it's true in my case. I just felt like it was rushed. Loki shows up, people stare at him, then he kills him. Why? Because he's evil. I just feel like Loki's motives was all over the place. I'm not saying he was a bad villain. No, he was terrifying at times, and Tom Hiddleston knows how to betray him. Though when the plot is good, or epic, let's say, it's when we get introduced to the Avengers. Every reveal in the movie of each Avenger seemed epic, with the Hulk, oddly, being the most epic. When he started to transform for the first time, that amount of buildup just to that scene. And I wasn't sure about Mark Ruffalo being the Hulk and all, but oddly enough, he's a good Hulk. I liked him as it. And if you look at the Hulk right here, you gotta see Mark Ruffalo in that. That is visual effects at its finest, ladies and gentlemen. And yet, Hulk punches those aliens in the face! And another Avenger, but you'll probably have to see the movie just to find out who that is. I will admit, Iron Man was close to being my favorite Avenger. Why? Robert Downey Jr. Now, in the last hour of this movie, if you don't grin once, you have no soul. It's all action, explosions, sounds like a Michael Bay film, but this one's good because it built up to it and it pays off. It just seems like the last 4 years of waiting for this movie was really paid off, and for the people who haven't seen it, I think you should see it. If you're a DC Comics fan and if you hate Marvel movies, something is wrong with you because this movie is really good and it gives a solid 9 out of 10 for me. I don't want to say The Avengers is the best movie of all time, like a certain amount of people think like Avatar is the best movie of all time. it was just a good way to start off the summer. And now it's fall. Why am I reviewing this again? Well, since I'm reviewing it, how about if I give you students who are probably watching this in the cafeteria or in your classrooms, how about if I give you a chance? What you can do, you can take a piece of paper just like this one, just rip it and write a good movie, bad movie, new movie, or, well, old movie, and just write it down and send it to Miss Gramley's classroom at, well, 1156. Drop it into this box and, yeah. I may allow games as well, but I'm not really edging towards that because I think everyone's going to recommend, like, Black Ops 2 or something like that. So overall, thank you for watching movie reviews, and I hope to maybe see y'all next time if this proved to be successful. I hope.
That was pretty cool. Nicole, what did you think?
I thought it was really entertaining, and I'm looking forward to the next one. This next piece is close to my heart personally, but it's relevant to all of us here at PHS. As Mr. Wright says, we are a family, and we all grow best with encouragement.
I want to take a moment to address a situation that has become a talking point in this community over the past weekend, especially on Facebook, that centers around me. On Friday, I received the following email from a La Crosse man with the subject line, Community Responsibility, and it reads as follows. Hi, Jennifer. It's unusual that I see your morning show, but I did so for a very short time today. I was surprised indeed to witness that your physical condition hasn't improved for many years. Surely you don't consider yourself a suitable example for this community's young people, girls in particular. Obesity is one of the worst choices a person can make and one of the most dangerous habits to maintain. I leave you this note hoping that you'll reconsider your responsibility as a local public personality to present and promote a healthy lifestyle. Now, those of us in the media, we get a healthy dose of critiques from our viewers throughout the year, and we realize that it comes with having a job in the public eye. But this email was more than that. While I tried my best to laugh off the very hurtful attack on my appearance, my colleagues could not do the same, especially my husband, our 6 and 10 anchor, Mike Thompson. Mike posted this email on his WKBT Facebook page, and what happened next has been truly inspiring. Hundreds and hundreds of people have taken the time out of their day to not only lift my spirits, but take a stand that attacks like this are not okay. Now, we're going to have more on that in just a second. But first, the truth is, I am overweight. You could call me fat, and yes, even obese on a doctor's chart. But to the person who wrote me that letter, do you think I don't know that? That your cruel words are pointing out something that I don't see? You don't know me. You are not a friend of mine. You are not a part of my family, and you have admitted that you don't watch this show. So you know nothing about me but what you see on the outside. And I am much more than a number on a scale. And here is where I want all of us to learn something from this. If you didn't already know, October is National Anti-Bullying Month, and this is a problem that is growing every day in our schools and on the internet. It is a major issue in the lives of young people today, and as the mother of three young girls, it scares me to death. Now, I am a grown woman, and luckily for me, I have a very thick skin, literally, as that email pointed out, and otherwise. And that man's words mean nothing to me. But what really angers me about this is there are children who don't know better, who get emails as critical as the one I received, or in many cases even worse, each and every day. The internet has become a weapon. Our schools have become a battleground, and this behavior is learned. It is passed down from people like the man who wrote me that email. If you are at home and you are talking about the fat news lady, guess what? Your children are probably going to go to school and call someone fat. We need to teach our kids how to be kind, not critical, and we need to do that by example. So many of you have come to my defense over the past 4 days. I am literally overwhelmed by your words. To my colleagues and my friends from today and from years ago, my family, my amazing husband, and so many of you out there that I will probably never have the opportunity to meet, I will never be able to thank you enough for your words of support and for taking a stand against this bully. We are better than that email. We are better than the bullies that would try to take us down. And I leave you with this. To all of the children out there who feel lost, who are struggling with your weight, with the color of your skin, your sexual preference, your disability, even the acne on your face, listen to me right now. Do not let your self-worth be defined by bullies. Learn from my experience that the cruel words of one are nothing.
In today's world, bullying can be an issue. It is important that we be aware of what we say to and around others. The smallest comment can have a great impact on someone's life.
I agree. This is definitely an issue to be taken seriously. We end this segment on a positive note, leaving you with a music video created by Jack Purdy. I'm Nicole Phillips.
And I'm Colby Thompson. Go Eagles!
Dreams we had.